Hello everyone, today I would like to show you how you can create your own Fine-tune models without writing a single line of code. So yeah, no need to install Python, because with Entry Point, which is a platform that me and Mark have been developing for the past 4 months, you'll be able to do that without writing any line of code. Now, for the purposes of this video, we'll be creating a classifier type of AI model. Specifically, we'll be classifying these keywords. Now, what do I mean by that? So here I have a list of 4,000 keywords that I got from a Google Ads campaign. Now I have to analyze these keywords. And to do that, I have to categorize them, right? Because keywords by themselves, they don't really mean nothing to me. So I have come up with 4 different types of categories, completely custom based on my logic. And now I can analyze them, right? So I can, after classified, I can now see how much people are converting. Right, and I can see that on use case type of keywords, they're not really converting that well, while on tool descriptor type of keywords, they're converting really well. Now, the problem is I've only used 120 keywords for this analysis, which is, of course, I have 4,000 keywords. It's not really that accurate, right? But doing this, classifying this manually would take me an entire day and it would be mind-numbingly boring, right? So let's fine-tune an AI model to do this for us. Now to start, I will simply take the examples that I already have, right? And paste them in a empty sheet and just download this as CSV. There we go. That's all that I need. Now I can go to Entry Point and create a new project. Let's go with PPC classifier, and we will make it a classifier type of project. You can also create generators in Entry Point, like generator type of models that produce some text, like a description of something, let's say an intro for an article, a story, whatever, doesn't really matter. But creating AI generators, it's a bit harder because the output is not black and white, right? With classifiers, it's either the output is either correct or it's incorrect. So it's very easy to create a classifier type of model. So we're going to go with that. Now we can create a blank project or a simple text prompt with category completion. I'll explain what this means in a moment. Or you can even use a tool that we have built in Entry Point that allows you to just write the URL and Entry Point will scrape the data from the website and then you can classify the data and use it however you want, right? So, but for now, we're just going to go with blank project, press create. Now to start, you can create fields and format them manually, which I'll show you how to do in a second. Or you can simply upload your CSV, just like that. I have uploaded the CSV and now we have to define the columns. What are the columns? Well, so first I have the category column. This should be the completion, right? And it should be one of the 4 predefined options. And the search term, so the keywords, they are just like a text type of a prompt, basically. Now I'm going to go continue. And I can now allocate a certain percentage of my examples, training data essentially, to be validation data. And what validation does is when once you send the data to OpenAI for fine-tuning, the validations are actually not going to be used for fine-tuning, they're going to be used to evaluate the health of the model, so the accuracy of the model, right? In my example, I don't really have much examples, only 120, so I'm going to go with 0 validation. And yeah, so the import has started. Now we're just going to wait a few seconds. There we go, it's done. So that was fast. And here are all my data points. Now, if I had a team and I had like a ton of examples, I could divide them into Entry Point and they could help me edit and label the data right here. Make sure that we have really awesome, high quality data for fine tuning. That's not the case with this simple classifier. It's very simple. Plus I have already prepared high quality data in the CSV, so I don't have to do that here, but that's an option and it's a super useful option. I can also change training to validation, right? So I can change that train data points to validation data points later and so on. Now, well, we're actually ready to start the fine tune. We simply have to pick a platform of our choice. So in my case, it's going to be OpenAI. I could also use AI21, which is another large language model provider. And in the future, we're going to have all of them. But for now, just OpenAI, and I simply have to enter my API key. And to find that, I have to go under my OpenAI account and just go under view API keys and just create a new secret key. Just copy that and then paste it into Entry Point. Save and just go back to our project. Now let's go to our fine tunes, click plus, and we can pick a model. In my case, I'm going to pick DaVinci, but keep in mind that Qt is also a wonderful model for creating classifier type of AI models. But in this case, I don't have many examples, so I really want, I'm just going to go with DaVinci so I can squeeze everything that I have out of the training data that I basically provided, right? And entry point is going to also calculate the number of tokens that I'm going to send to fine tuning. And it's going to calculate the cost, right? Now I have some advanced options here, which is setting the number of epochs and prompt loss weights and so on. We can leave this as it is. And now we can simply press start. And yeah, so the fine tuning job has started. So now entry point is sending all the examples to OpenAI. And now we're simply waiting for them to fine tune the model and send it back to us essentially, right? Now this fine tuning job, this fine-tuning model is named Teal Panda. And so entry point will always name your models with a color and an animal. And we do that just so that it's easy to navigate once you have like 5-10 different models. Instead of looking at some complex strings, we have colorful animals. Okay, so we're going to wait for this to finish. And in the meantime, I'm going to show you templates and fields, because this is really where entry point shines. They might be daunting to get into, and by all means, you can just do your models the way I showed you right here, but templates and fields really unlock additional possibilities with entry point. So let me show you an example of how you would use that and when you would use that. Okay, so I'm going to create another test project. Let's go with, story generator test. I don't know. This is going to be a generator, just a blank project. And here I'm going to manually set the fields and the templates, okay? There we go. So this is going to be the text. Now, if you were to just use a normal prompt, you would have to actually set up the fields like this. This would be the prompt, target is the prompt. There we go. And now we also need a completion, okay? Just like that. Now, the reason why I made it like this, now I can go under templates, and the prompt is just going to be one big variable and the completion as well. So if I go under examples and I create a new prompt completion data point, let's say that write a story about a female spider queen named Ike, right? And then we can have the story here. Ike was a blah, blah, blah. Okay. So that would be an example of creating a generator type of AI model. And we will go save a next, and then we would create another like prompt. Write a story about a orc, a male orc named John. Then John is blah, blah. Okay. So that's how we would add the data points. Now, in this project, we can see that I will always have in my prompts, like I can, you know, predict this, I'm going to have a gender, a race, and a name, okay? So doing this manually every time opens up the possibility for mistakes, and it's really time consuming. So instead, what I can do, I can go back to my fields, and I'm going to delete, actually, I'm going to leave the completion. I'm going to delete the prompt. I'm going to create a new text field, which will be named name. Be the prompt. I'm going to create a new text field, which will be the race. And another one, gender. There we go. Okay. And now I can go under templates. This doesn't exist anymore. And I can go write a story about, let's go with this named name. There we go. Save. Could go on examples. And so the name here is John. Race is, I don't know, human. Was he human? And male. Okay. Right now, I can just save this. And the prompt adopted, right? So it fits the template. Now I can just enter the variables and all the examples will adapt. So this was Ike, spider queen, female. There we go. Okay. Now, once I have the prompts styled like this. Now I can go back here and change the template. And I'll draft a story. Can save this. And all examples will now change as well, right? So I won't have to manually, change anything later on the project, right? So that's really useful. Now, what about, what if you have a ton of data points and they're incomplete? What if you don't always have a name, for example? Well, in that case, we actually build in handlebar logic inside these templates. Now, this is really, really advanced use, but with handlebar logic, you can actually create if statements. Let me show you what I mean. So here we can go with if name is not null, well then I should simply pick a name. Simply have the name. But if that's not the case, else, let's go with Kevin. Let's close the if. There we go. Save. We go back to our examples. And now we can create a data point like human, male. This is a story about, there we go, Kevin, right? So it otherwise it would have been empty. The prompt would be incomplete, but now we gave it a default value. It does take some energy to learn this, but once you do, I mean, you can just create and manage such huge data sets of examples, and it's going to be beautiful. Yeah. Let's get back to our classifier. I'm actually going to go with another one that I fine-tuned a while ago on the same data set, just because the other one is going to take an hour and a half. So just want to show you this right now. Okay, so this is the fine-tune. This one is named Gray Loose, not Teal Panda anymore, but it's ready. And now I can just click this button and it's going to open it up in Playground. It's right over here. Now I can test if this works. So let me just pick a random keyword like this one, paste it in here and add the stop sequence, a stop sequence here as well, submit. We should probably lower the temperature to 0. And it's a tool descriptor. That's right. That's perfect classification. Let's go one more, web merge support. Yeah, the competitor brand. So it works. Now I also have Playground in entry point. So I can quite literally do the same thing. So I simply select my model here, run completion. And I can see the correct completion here. In the future, we're also going to have an option for you to upvote or downvote the completions, or even change them, tweak them. And once you change them, you can actually save them to examples for future fine-tuning. That's for classifier type projects. For generator type of projects, we're actually going to have an AI generate the examples, run the completions with your model, and then provide you a few completions, like 2 to 3, which you can then pick whichever you like the most, which is an extremely efficient way to fine-tune your model even more, right? So yeah, that's coming. Now let's use our model in our actual project. So I'm going to go back to my keyword list. And I'm going to go here and write completions or categories. Yeah. Categories. There we go. And I'm going to run this function that I made, which calls that model. And there we go. Completes it. Just like that. Easy. Join PDF files online for free. That's a use case. Tool descriptor, free online PDF editor. That's right. Windows Studios, that's a competitor. There we go, right? And we have our fine-tuned model that can classify these keywords. So that's it. And if you also want to integrate your newly fine-tuned AI model into Google Sheets, just like I have over here with a new custom function, well, I have a tutorial on that for our newsletter subscribers or for our Discord members. So make sure you either join our email list or join our Discord, and I'll send you over that video. And if you would like to use Entry Point to fine-tune your AI models, well then, there's a sign-up link right below. It's currently in open beta, which means it's still free. It's not going to be the case forever. So make sure you